cinema of the 1990s. The best movies, the best actors, CGI, the rise of African-American filmmakers, and the rise of independent films and new studios. Perhaps the best way to discuss trends in the 90s is to say there were no trends. A few films continued the fast action, fun to watch blockbuster style that was popular in the 1980s, but many others created films with serious themes: Philadelphia, Schindler's List, Forrest Gump, Braveheart. A few Westerns, or at least Native American films, continued. And of course, romances are popular in every age, but these are genres, not trends. Titanic became the first movie to gross $1 billion, the most financially successful film of all time, surpassing Gone with the Wind. It was also the most expensive film in Hollywood history. It tied Ben-Hur with its 11 Oscar wins. In 1991, Silence of the Lambs swept the top five Oscars: picture, director, actor, actress, and writer. Although often classified as horror, it definitely has a noir feel about it, and the following its success was a string of neo-noir films: Fight Club, Seven, Eyes Wide Shut, Primal Fear, L.A. Confidential, The Usual Suspects, The Game, True Romance, Heat, even The Fugitive, Pulp Fiction. There were several films portraying the heroic: Apollo 13, Saving Private Ryan, and A Few Good Men. The 1990s saw the rise of African-American filmmakers, especially Spike Lee with Jungle Fever, Clockers, and Malcolm X, but also Albert and Alan Hughes with Menace to Society, and Mario Van Peebles with New Jack City. In the late 1980s and continuing on into the 1990s, leading figures of Hong Kong action cinema, personalities like Jackie Chan, Jet Li, Chow Yun-fat, Michelle Yeoh, and others, migrated to Hollywood. The Little Mermaid in 89 began Disney's Renaissance age, followed by Beauty and the Beast, Aladdin, The Lion King, Hercules, Mulan. It seemed to be one success after another for the Disney company. And Disney wasn't alone. We had The Nightmare Before Christmas, The Prince of Egypt, The Underappreciated Iron Giant, Bug's Life, and James and the Giant Peach, all giving Disney competition for producing excellent children's films. Princess Mononoke flew under the radar, but was a predictor of the coming success of Studio Ghibli. The 90s saw CGI move in a strong way. Dick Tracy in 90 was the first 35mm feature film with a digital soundtrack. But it was Jurassic Park in 93 that changed film forever with its successful use of CGI. The Phantom Menace included characters that were entirely digitally rendered, such as Jar Jar Binks. And in 95, Toy Story became the first feature-length film to be completely computer animated. A strong power behind the CGI movement was George Lucas's company, Industrial Light and Magic. In 1993, CGI was still largely unproven, both in the industry and in the box office. Hollywood was hesitant to gamble on high-tech special effects. Moviegoers had yet to accept CGI as anything more than a novelty. Their creators had to advance the technology to the point where the seam between illusion and reality completely disappeared. Jurassic Park did that. Spielberg told Tom Schoen that when he saw Industrial Light and Magic's first test shot of the dinosaurs, he felt as though he was watching our future unfolding on the TV screen. George Lucas, who was also there, recalled it was one of those moments in history, like the invention of the light bulb or the first telephone call. A major gap had been crossed, and things were never going to be the same. He was right. Jurassic Park heralded a revolution in movies as profound as the coming of sound in 1927. During 1990s, cinema also moved from the traditional single big screen theaters to multi-screen cinema complexes, that offered smaller screens but more choices. The 1990s also saw the DVD appear. Many films, some estimates say 40%, went directly to video or cable with no cinematic theatrical release at all. 1990s saw the notable rise of independent cinema and independent cinema studios like Miramax, Lionsgate, and New Line. In 1999, Eduardo Sanchez and Daniel Myricks' roughly made independent film The Blair Witch Project was released. It was a pseudo-documentary about a tragic camping trip and the investigation of a local legend. This film featured no-name actors. It was directed by students of the University of Central Florida in 8 days. It was distributed by small-time Artesian Films. It had a very low budget of $60,000 and was innovatively shot on 16mm black and white and color digital film. It had no state-of-the-art special effects, no creatures, no monsters. But it foretold the new world of internet-based marketing. Other notable films from the 90s include Good Will Hunting, The Green Mile, Jumanji, and The Sixth Sense. The Thin Red Line, The Crying Game, Scent of a Woman, and Legends of the Fall. Fargo, A River Runs Through It, Rudy, Anna and the King, and Jerry Maguire. 7 of these top films were Disney products. Tom Hanks appeared in 7 of these. Julia Roberts appeared in 5. Robin Williams was the star of 4 of these films, as was Harrison Ford. Bruce Willis appeared in 5, although 2 of them were sequels. Demi Moore appeared in 3. 18% of the top grossing films were nominated or won Best Picture at the Academy Awards. And here are the Academy Awards.